welcome to Pentecost Sunday at Ascension and Holy Trinity in Pueblo, Colorado. We begin our service, if you're following along at home, on page 355 of the Book of Common Prayer. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, on this day you opened the way of eternal life to every race and nation by the promised gift of your Holy Spirit. Shed abroad this gift throughout the world by the preaching of the gospel, that it may reach to the end of the earth through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
First lesson today is from the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 through 21. When the day of Pentecost had come, the disciples were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues, as of fire, appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages, as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heaven above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. The response today is from Psalm 104, verses 25 through 35 and 37. Benedict, anima mia. O Lord, how manifold are your works! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Yonder is the great and wide sea, with its living things too many to number, creatures both small and great. There move the ships, and there is that Leviathan, which you have made for the sport of it. All of them look to you, to give them their food in due season. You give it to them, they gather it. You open your hand and they are filled with good things. You hide your face and they are terrified. You take away their breath and they die and return to their dust. You send forth your spirit and they are created. And so you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in all his works. He looks at the earth and it trembles. He touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will praise my God while I have my being. May these words of mine please him. I will rejoice in the Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Hallelujah.
Go. Second lesson is from 1 Corinthians. No one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, the discernment of spirits. To another, various kinds of tongues. To another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
reading from the Gospel of John. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." In the name of the one who made us in love, who saved us for love, and who loves us still, amen. There is a saying from the Mishnah, "By three things the world is preserved, by justice, by truth, and by peace. And these three are one. If justice has been accomplished, so has truth, and so has peace." By three things the world is preserved, by justice, by truth, and by peace. And these three are one. If justice has been accomplished, so has truth, and so has peace. On this pandemic Pentecost, we remember and celebrate the gift of God's holy breath, filling the followers of Jesus as they are sent, as Jesus was sent, to embody and give voice to the way of love. And on this pandemic Pentecost, I find myself wondering if maybe, just maybe, God is renewing the face of the church. I find myself wondering if God is calling us to remember how the renewing, recreative spirit of the living God led the first followers of Jesus into new life that was fraught not just with uncertainty, but also potential danger. On that first Pentecost, the Holy Spirit, the untamed and creative Spirit of God that moves across the chaos of shaken foundations and certainties, was present with the first disciples as they left the upper room and went out into the public squares, only to fall powerfully upon them like flames of fire, mirroring Caesar's self-understanding and identification as the Son of God and therefore divine. I find myself wondering if God is calling us to remember the challenge this would have been to the powers that were, to the status quo. I find myself wondering if in this pandemic Pentecost, we are being led in our own uncertainties, in the midst of a kind of danger many of us have never known, to be present as the church in new ways that may be more than we would ever have seen or even imagined. I do find myself wondering. And on this pandemic Pentecost, as we remember, we are also confronted with today's realities of race and justice, the experience of which surely contradicts everything the mission of the first followers of Jesus embodied. And again, I wonder if the Spirit of the living God challenges us to remember and reclaim that where justice is accomplished, there is truth and there is peace. And in this is the world healed and renewed. At this time in our country, in the midst of pandemic unrest, maybe, just maybe, the Spirit is leading us into deeper witness to the justice of God. The justice in which there is truth and peace. For as Jesus said time and time again, we are sent as He was sent. We are to love as we have been loved. We are to serve not counting the cost, but being willing to lose our lives for the sake of another. Maybe, just maybe, this pandemic Pentecost will lead us into remembrance and renewal of the first Pentecost with humility and with power. And in this spirit and in this hope, I'd like to share with you a statement given by our Bishop Kim Lucas, Bishop James Gumia of the ELCA, and Bishop Karen Olivetta of the United Methodist Church. They say, together we join our voices. As faith leaders in Colorado, we join our voices to speak to the current pain, suffering, anger, and anguish confronting our communities and our nation. The hard reality of COVID-19 has not only disrupted life as we know it, it has laid bare the disparities in our country. Recent events, including the murder of George Floyd, have revealed with stark clarity the continuing scourge of injustice, racism, and white supremacy in our midst. George Floyd's name joins a litany of people of color who have suffered abuse and have been murdered simply because of their skin tone. In light of such atrocities and unholy acts, we join our voices to speak together. Together we join our voices to mourn and grieve with those who have experienced the trauma of persecution, violence, suffering, and death. Together, we join our voices to bear witness to the stark truth that there is no equal protection under the law in our nation. Indeed, there never has been. Together, we join our voices to acknowledge our own failure and the failure of our churches to heed the cries of our Black, Brown, and Native siblings regarding undue violence from law enforcement. Together we join our voices to honor our calling to speak out against the profiling, persecution, and execution of our siblings of color. Together we join our voices to renounce acts of violence from the state, from protesters, or from organized groups trying to incite violence at protests. Together, we join our voices to affirm our commitment as followers of Jesus to seek and demand equality and justice. Together, we join our voices to hold our governmental authorities accountable for training our police officers in de-escalation and cross-cultural understanding. Together, we join our voices and we to offer our prayers of support and affirmation for our communities and the law enforcement officers who fulfill their obligations and duties faithfully and compassionately. Together, we join our voices and recommit ourselves as fellow children of God to do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with our God. Together, these bishops who lead us have have pledged to guide their respective faith communities in doing the same. Amen. Melanus proclaim together our historic Christian faith in the form of the Nicene Creed. If you are following along in your prayer book, it's page 358. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
I ask your prayers for God's people throughout the world, for our presiding bishop, Michael, our bishop, Kim, for our clergy, and for all ministers and people. Pray for the church. I ask your prayers for peace, for goodwill among nations, and for the well-being of all people. We pray for our President Donald, our Governor Jared, our Mayor Nick, and for our city and county governments. Pray for justice and peace. I ask your prayers for the poor, the sick, the hungry, the oppressed, those in prison, those experiencing homelessness and unemployment. Pray for those in any need or trouble. I ask your prayers for all who seek God or a deeper knowledge of God. Pray that they may find him, pray that they may find and be found by him. I ask your prayers for the departed. Pray for those who have died. In this time of unrest, heightened by COVID-19, I ask your prayers for mercy, but especially for your justice, for without justice, there can be no real peace. Praise God for those in every generation in whom Christ has been honored. Pray that we may have grace to glorify Christ in our own day.
Now let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. And now let us pray together the prayer that we have been taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now may the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And may the blessing of the one, holy, undivided Trinity be with you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Amen.
Oh, striving through her age. time or feel the Spirit.